Good morning. I'm at Horseshoe Meadow in Inyo National Forest. I packed my pack with 8 days of food, and I'm gonna head north and see where I end up. Both Mount Langley and Mount Whitney is in front of me, so depending on the smoke from the fires and conditions, I might try for one or two of those, but I don't have any set plan. There's some fires just south of us, and they've been causing a lot of smoke over the last week or two. So that could definitely be a consideration when it comes to picking the route. Today I'm just gonna head up to Cottonwood Lake number 5 and make that my first camp. Here we go. I'm gonna leave the main trail here and head up a different route to the Cottonwood Lakes, just because I've never gone up this way before. Have some variation. Let's see how it looks. This alternative route up the South Fork of Cottonwood Creek is actually a really good trail. Here's an old shelter. Maybe it's a hunting cabin, hunting shelter or something. I have no idea. I got my first look at some real Sierra Nevada mountains here. Beautiful. To the right there is Cirque Peak. Got my first wildlife out here. Up here in the distance is New Army Pass. That's not where I'm going. I'm gonna try the old Army Pass tomorrow. Thank you. I have reached Cottonwood Lakes. Now I'm gonna keep heading up into the basin here to reach Cottonwood Lake number 5, where I'm camping, just below Old Army Pass. This is Mount Langley up here. 14,000 and something feet. Gonna climb up over this neck at the head of the lake here to get to Cottonwood Lake number 4 and 5. Here is Army Pass that I'm planning to head up and over tomorrow. It's getting hazy now from the smoke. It's clearer in the morning. It was a little bit too windy and I couldn't find any shade up at Cottonwood Lake number 5, so I came down to this lake again and found this beautiful camp spot here, both shade from the sun and from the wind. Perfect. Here's a little look around camp. You can see how hazy it's getting because of the fires. I'm tucked in down here. I decided I wanted to provide some maps for this longer version of the video. I used this Sequoia Kings Canyon National Parks map from National Geographic. They do not provide a lot of details, but I like them a lot combined with my GPS on my phone. So here we go. On day one, I started from Horseshoe Meadow here and headed up the trail until I crossed the creek and followed this South Fork here to the junction. And then as I got to the Cottonwood Lakes, followed the New Army Pass trail to here and went up to Cottonwood Lake number 3. I had originally planned to camp at number 5 up here, but after heading up and having a look and seeing that I couldn't find any shade and the wind was picking up, I headed down to Cottonwood Lake number 3 again and camped right here. Beautiful camp spot. It's day number 2. I've started walking up towards Army Pass. From there, I'm gonna see if I'm gonna climb Mount Langley, if the conditions are good and I'm feeling well. Mount Langley is over 14,000 feet high, so the elevation will play into the consideration there. It's a beautiful morning, stunning at Cottonwood Lakes.
gonna climb up Army Pass, up and over here. Looks pretty exciting. Army Pass has always interested me, and this is gonna be exciting. There's a few people up front here. Gonna have to make my way up there. Excited for this. I think I can spot an arch up there. Awesome. Look at these amazing cliffs around this basin. Pretty intimidating. Now the trick is to take it very slowly. I'm gonna try to pace myself. Looking back at Cottonwood Lake number 4, there's good camping here, right down at the foot of the pass. Beautiful place, really cool pass. You just don't want to fall. It's a long ways down. Made it to the top of Army Pass, and I'm now gonna be entering Sequoia National Park. Gonna head up to Mount Langley now. Thinking it's this way. Wow. Look at the smoke out here. Mount Langley. That's my goal. Hello there, friend.
Hey there.
Smoke, smoke, smoke. I'm just passing 12,500 feet of elevation. That's 3,800 meters. And it's time to drop some weight from my pack for the final 1500 feet of elevation gain. Gonna leave my bear canister with my food and some other stuff here. Just bring some food and clothing and water, emergency kit to the summit. Starting to get some incredible views here. This is looking south, east. Here you can see the gap where Army Pass is, where I came up. And over there you can see New Army Pass. Thank you.
Are you in my fall zone?
Here's the Cottonwood Lakes that I camped at. Pretty far down. Last cairn, final summit push. That flat spot up there. Summit. Here we are, Mount Langley, 4,275 meters, 14,000 and some change feet. Let's see. How it looks. This. Lone pine out there. Mount Whitney. Independence way out there. And no smoke on Mount Whitney. Awesome. No wind here at all. Completely quiet. Looking over towards all the smoke and fires. Absolutely stunning. Fourteen thousand and 26 feet. Down here, you can see Sky Blue Lake. That's a goal from my trip. And Mount Whitney, out here. Highest mountain in the lower 48 states. No smoke on that today. Independence out there. Looks like a new fire just starting up down there. Okay, it's time to head down again. The wind is picking up and it looks like the smoke from the fires might be heading this way. Pretty crazy smoke now. That's actually Telescope Peak in Death Valley over there to the left. Horseshoe Meadow down there. The flat, scree-covered ridge. Bit of a class 3 coming down here. What a marvelous place. It's a great mountain, highly recommended. Smoke is coming in. Plan is to get down to an unnamed lake down here and then turn and head east towards Sky Blue Lake. I'm planning to camp a little bit before Sky Blue Lake, actually. Came down here, kind of fun scree walking. Steep but fun. Just a little bit of contrast to all the big mountains and rocks and slabs. A little tiny little stream. This is pretty nice. If I was a bear, I'd live in here. Thank you. over here is the trail I have to get on. Wonder how I'm gonna do that. Do I have to drop all the way down or? It's getting really hot. Seems like I found an old trail here. Gonna see if I can follow that down before I climb again. Look at this crazy smoke now. I don't like this. I came down this, bushwhacking through here, and now I'm gonna turn and climb up this. Okay, I'm nearly at the top. Nothing fun about climbing that chute there. That was not my favorite. Not recommended. But it could be worth it in the end. Let's see. Found a pretty little pond here. This would have been incredible without all the smoke. Looks fantastic. Cool lake down here. I'm planning to camp in those trees in there. Get some shelter from the wind. On the trail again. Now just a little bit and then I'll set up camp. What an eerie sight. Langley is up here somewhere. That's where I was around noon today. Up here is the Mitre that this basin is named after. The Mitre Basin. Pretty cool peak. I'm not sure if that's how you say it, but that's my best guess. Stunning valley. I reached the area where I was planning to look for a camp. And looks like there's several good spots in here. Nobody else in here today, so I'll just take the one that I feel good about. On day two, I headed up from Cottonwood Lake number three, between the two Cottonwood Lakes four and five, and up and over the amazing Army Pass. On the ridge here, there was a trail, took me up here, and then it turns into All Cairns. I dropped my supplies here before I started going up the route that is now new and has big cairns on it. The Park Service is, or the Forest Service is encouraging everyone to follow this new route. It has some massive cairns on it. So I just made my way up to the summit. After the summit, I came back down the same way, picked up my gear, and then went off trail. There's a little bit of a used trail going down here, but I came down to the upper Soldier Lake and made my way down here. I was thinking I might have been able to traverse up here without dropping, but I ended up dropping down to the lower Soldier Lake and then going up this drainage here. I stayed off trail. There's a route here, but you can't really see it because it's not there, but it's there because there was a cairn right here taking me down into the basin. So I ended up camping in here on the second night. A very smoky evening there. Beautiful spot.
It's day three. It's 6:50 a.m. in the morning. And it looks like the smoke cleared out completely during the night. It's been a pretty windy night, so I haven't gotten the best sleep, but I'm really happy to see the smoke is gone.
Up here's the miter without the smoke. Sun is about to come up over here. That's just over Mount Langley.
I have started day number three. I'm gonna head up to Sky Blue Lake first and then over Crabtree Pass and down to make camp at the lower Crabtree Lake. That's what I think my plan is. I don't know too much about Crabtree Pass. Heard it can be a little bit difficult. Have no idea. So we just have to see how this goes. It's a beautiful day.
Sky Blue Lake. I saw this from above at Mount Langley yesterday. Pretty cool. You can see why it's called Sky Blue Lake. To the left there is the summit of Mount Langley, where I was yesterday. So much beauty everywhere.
Love this little pond here. Sky Blue Lake, New Army Pass way out in the distance, Mount Langley, and I'm heading this way. Last lake before the pass here. Amazing colors in the water here. There's the pass. Got Crabtree Pass up there, the notch. That's the goal. That was nice to have a little break. Now it's time to head up and over the pass.
It's a good day to be alive. There's another pretty lake. Passes in here. A lot of route finding in here today. Not too difficult, but slow going. Wow, look at this lake here. Amazing. Wow, beautiful. Look at the colors. Colors are insane. Wow. Thank you.
by now. Prettiest lake in the world. Stunning. Wow, look at the fire building. That's crazy. Gotta get over the pass before smoke hits me. The pass is up there in the gap. Very curious about how it looks on the other side. Okay, at Crabtree Pass, I'm gonna head down this way. Came up here. I'm gonna head down this way. So I'm at Crabtree Pass now. I've been kind of nervous about going down on the other side here. I have no idea about what it looks like. I've been hearing a few stories about how sketchy and dangerous it is, so I haven't looked down it yet. It's gonna be exciting. Let's see how it looks. All right, here's the look down into the Crabtree Lakes Basin. Yeah, it's pretty steep, so gotta go careful here. Ooh. Yeah, that's definitely quite sketchy. Takes a lot of feeling to get down safely. So, I'm gonna keep going. Not filming much coming down here. I'm doing a few class 3, class 4 moves instead of staying in the scree. So, not much filming. I came from up here, been making my way down through these slabs here. And gonna continue down here. Pretty lakes. Crabtree Lakes Basin. It almost looks like there might have been an easier way down here. That looks way more doable than what I did. If anybody knows, please leave a comment down below the video. I would appreciate that very much. So this is the one that I think looks easier. And I came down this one all over to the southern side. I think that's what it is. Southern side of the pass. This one definitely looks easier. As far as I can see from down here, you never know what's going on higher up though. I think I'm down. I did come down this way here. That was, yeah, not fun. But I do think this looks easier and better. I do not know if you can get all the way over the pass here though, so I'm wondering.
Let's try to find a way around a lake. I think the other shore there should be the right way. Beautiful lake. Time to head this way along the shore. Crabtree Pass. Look at the beautiful water, stunning colors. Grand Prismatic Springs. I have rounded the upper Crabtree Lake, and it's a pretty cool lake here. Very remote and beautiful. Following the beautiful Crabtree Creek down the valley. I found camp as the smoke is starting to come in. Making some pasta bolognese today. Oh.
really cool mountains around camp here.
Crazy is this sun. On day 3, I went off trail, up, climbed to the left here, up to Sky Blue Lake, rounded Sky Blue Lake on the right side, went up the creek drainages here, round here, and up to this beautiful lake where I had lunch. And then I went up to a ridge here, followed that into this basin where the most pretty lake I've ever seen was located. You can see it's a tiny little spot here. That was amazing. Over Crabtree Pass, down into the Crabtree Basin, to the right of this lake, and down Crabtree Creek, and I camped somewhere in here. There's a ton of great camps here. You can just pick and choose depending on where the wind is coming from. So that's the end of day 3. Here's my gravity system. That's the cool thing about the Sawyer Squeeze, is that you can use it for both ordinary squeeze system, and then you can set up this thing here to have a little bit of gravity setup. The trick is to use the blue mouthpiece, because that fits into a smart bottle or any bottle like this. Saves me a lot of work just setting it up and letting it stand here while I make my breakfast. Beautiful morning at Crabtree Lakes.
All right, looks like I have a trail here now, close to the lower Crabtree Lake. Lower Crabtree Lake. Beautiful clear water. Leaving Crabtree Lakes here. I have reached what I believe to be the upper part of Crabtree Meadow. Look at this pinnacle, probably part of the Mount Whitney complex. I have reached a junction with the main trail, and I am planning to meet a couple of friends from the Seeky Loop that I did earlier this summer, and they're supposed to be down here somewhere, so I'm gonna head south and see if I can run into them. And then we're gonna continue together from here. Heading south now to see if I can run into my friends. I have reached the PCT. Gonna keep heading south towards Rock Creek to see if I can find my friends. Finally at Geert Pass. Okay, gonna head down this pass so I can get some water. I'm at Geert Creek, waiting for my friends. It's only 2:30, so might be a while before they show up, depending on how far they got yesterday from Horseshoe Meadow. Look who showed up, my friends!
What's up? from the Big Seeky Loop. Yeah. Same crew, minus two. Rhyme Zone.
What's up?
What's up?
What's good? Where are the snacks at?
The snakes?
The snacks.
Snacks. Snacks are right here.
Excellent.
On day four, I started from my great camp up here, stayed high up to the right of this Crabtree Lake, and then dropped down and found a trail that took me down past the lower Crabtree Lake and down to Crabtree Meadow. Waited for my friends a little bit here and decided to head towards them to where we had agreed to meet. So I went down to the PCT, followed the PCT across Guyot Flat, Guyot Pass, and down to Guyot Creek, where I met my friends. Day four ended here.
It's day five. The sun is finally up.
Okay, it's day number five. I met my friends at Guyot Creek yesterday. So now we're turning around and heading up north towards Mount Whitney and Guitar Lake, where we're gonna camp tonight. We're planning on summiting Mount Whitney tomorrow morning, so I'm excited to do that. It's gonna be my first time up there, and from what I learned from Mount Langley, it's pretty spectacular. So really looking forward to this. Beautiful day again. Sun is out and no smoke in sight. Pretty much at Guyot Pass again, which is right here. Here's a little bit of a view actually. It's prettier going north than going south. We're getting close to Crabtree Meadow. You can see it right down here. Heading for Mount Whitney.
big smoke plume coming up here. It's around 12:30. It's a bit early for that. Let's hope the majority of the smoke stays away. Here we are at Timberline Lake. It's a pretty nice spot for a little break here. And up there is Whitney. Quite awesome. What are you saying, buddy? Yeah, there you go. We're in the Guitar Lake Basin here. We have reached Guitar Lake. A lot of people here. I think we're just gonna keep going for a bit. I think we found our camp just above Guitar Lake. Right here.
smoky. Some alpenglow on Mount Whitney. Too cool.
On day five, we started from Geert Creek, headed over Geert Pass, up the PCT, made a right here, went to Crabtree Ranger Station, where we intersected the JMT, followed the JMT up to Guitar Lake, and camped right here.
It's the morning of our ascent to Mount Whitney. It's about 6 a.m. We have some daylight. Most people have already left this campsite or this area and gone up to watch the sunrise. Guitar Lake. Where we camped, it's smoky out there. Let's hope we get some clear skies up ahead. It's a little past 6 in the morning. We have started our climb towards Mount Whitney. I could see most people started early so they could get up and see the sunrise from up there. Me personally, I prefer seeing all the beautiful mountains around me while I'm hiking up. So I'd much rather see that than a sunrise. Each to their own. So whatever makes you happy. But I really love the scenery here. It's
stunning and majestic. Gonna be a fun hike up. The switchbacks are up in here somewhere. You might see some people in there. Mount Whitney is up there somewhere. We have to go around and do the switchbacks. What an amazing trail. This is so cool. Down there are my friends. They were a little bit slower to start today. Looks like that could be a new fire out to the northwest. Building pretty fast. No wonder it's so smoky this morning.
call this under the hawk's nose, under the eagle's nose. On the other side of this ridge here, you have the Crabtree Lakes Basin. That's where I was 3 days ago. Camping right under that most distant wall there. Looks like we're getting close to trail crest. A lot of people up there. First look over to the east here, between two pinnacles. Smoky. So we have to go through here, and the summit should be up on the other side there. Thank you.
Out here is Bighorn Plateau and Forrester Pass behind that. But it's probably hidden in the smoke.
Gonna keep heading this way up to the summit. Up there. It's so cool here. Amazing.
Down here is Guitar Lake, where we camped.
Here's another look through a crack. Spectacular. So smoky out by Lone Pine.
On a bridge here, between the two sides of the divide. Pretty awesome.
Here's the hut on the summit. Still a ways to go.
This walk across the crest here must be one of the best walks in the world. It's absolutely stunning. Insane views. A lot of smoke today, but on a clear day it would be even more spectacular. There's Mount Langley that I was on a few days ago. Pretty prominent 14er. Very cool mountain. The one in the back there. Out there is Bighorn Plateau and Forrester Pass. Final push now. Should be there any minute. But there's probably a false summit. I'll take that into consideration as well. Came along this ridge here. Great, great walk. What a view. All right, here we are. There's the hut. Highest point in the lower 48 states. Mount Whitney. Awesome. Mount Whitney.
This is down towards Whitney Portal. Just completely smoked in. That's where we're heading.
That's a long way down. Incredible.
Oh yeah, I didn't catch you in the beginning.
So Forrester Pass should be out here somewhere. We are leaving Mount Whitney. Back with my friends. We were parted for the ascent, and now we're gonna be together for the descent. Out here is Bighorn Plateau, one of my favorite places to camp. Here's Mount Russell. Back here is Mount Williamson. You can actually see the top of Crabtree Pass out here. The pass I was on the third day of this trip. Yeah. Back at the bridge.
It's gotta be the best trail in the world. So awesome. Quite the incredible trail. Leaving Sequoia National Park now. Okay, we're preparing to head down to Whitney Portal, which is about 8.5 miles, steep downhill, 99 switchbacks, they call it. It's gonna be interesting. It's like we're walking into oblivion here. Got really smoky. Whitney is up there somewhere. In the smoke now. Switchbacks. It's a little bit of a fence here. Don't know why, it's pretty wide here, but it's cool. To get to Mount Whitney, we were hiking behind all these pinnacles here. Over to Mount Whitney, which should be up there, I think.
That could be the summit of Mount Whitney, beyond those pinnacles in the background there. Still got a long ways to go into the smoke. On day 6, the last day, the stunning day up to Mount Whitney, we followed the JMT basically to Mount Whitney, and then we went back down to Trailcrest and followed the trail all the way down here to Whitney Portal, where we ended our trip.